Good day, marketers! So today, I am here to discuss the topic regarding on unique selling process. So first, let me define you the meaning of USP or unique selling process, where it means that it is a factor or consideration presented by a seller as the reason that one product or service is different and better from that of the competition. The meaning says it all, which means that the topic is all about on how seller would sell the products or service on its unique way. The concept of how the strategy of marketing and advertising the product would be different to other product in order to catch the attention of the customers. Just like what other business owner says, before you can begin to sell your product or service to anyone else, you have to sell yourself on it. So this is especially important when your product or service is similar to anyone else. So you need to give yourself to your job in able to gain more customers, and you need to aim the trust of the people around you to build a better customer relationship. So let me give you a scenario where there has a trust-based selling that happened between a seller and a buyer. So trust-based selling is positioning yourself in a way with your potential clients that they trust your advice when you prescribe an offer or solution to their pain points and issues. So for example, popular fast food chain company such as Jollibee, McDonald's, KFC, and other trusted food company. We all know that this time of pandemic, we are limited to go outside and eat to our favorite restaurant. So in order to satisfy our cravings, we go order online and wait for our food. So this case is one of the example of trust-based selling, where there has a strong trust that build on the customers because they all know that they buy a quality product from the store and they don't need to ask any question because the fact that the business operates more than a year, which means it has a quality and trustworthy staffs and employees to talk to. So let's move on to the sales process. So what is sales process? It is a clear, repeatable, and sales process enables your representative to understand exactly what they need to do in order to succeed. It is also helps the sales managers plan out well-defined sales cycles that can generate more revenue with less effort. So let's proceed to the steps in sales process. There are 7 steps of sales process, which is prospecting, preparation, approach, presentation, handling objections, closing, and lastly, follow-up. So the sales process consists of 7 steps, which is the first step is the prospecting. In this stage, you find the potential customers and determine whether they have a need for your product or service and whether they can afford what you offer. They can also evaluate whether the customer needs your product or service and can afford it is known as qualifying. The second stage has you in preparation for initial contact with the potential customers, researching the market and collecting all relevant information regarding your product or service. And at this point, you develop your sales presentation and tailor it to your potential client's particular needs. The next is approach. In approach stage, you make first contact with your client, and sometimes this is a face-to-face meeting, sometimes it's over the phone, and there are 3 common approach methods, which is the first is premium approach, where it presents your potential client with a gift at the beginning of your interaction. So the second is question approach, and it is the approach where asking a question to get the prospect interested. And the last approach is the product approach, where it is giving the prospect a sample of a pre-trial to review and evaluate your service. Then the fourth step is presentation. In the presentation phase, you actively demonstrate how your product or service meets the needs of your potential customers. And the word presentation implies using PowerPoint and giving a sales list file, but it doesn't always have to be that way. You should actively listen to your customer needs and then act and react accordingly.
After that is the handling objections. In this stage, you will assess the concerns and issues that will get from the buyers. Seller is going to give answers on the problems and objections that the buyer will be giving.
The sixth step is closing. In the closing stage, you get the decision from the client to move forward. And depending on your business, you might try one of these three closing techniques, which is the first one is alternative choice close. Assuming the sales and offering the prospect a choice where both options close the sales. For example, will you be paying the whole fee upfront or in installments, or will that be cash or charge? So, as you can see in the example, there has a choice between paying installation or in cash. So, the second one is extra inducement close. So, offering something extra to get the prospect to close, such as free month of service or a discount. The third one is standing room only close. So, creating urgency by expressing that time is one of this essence. For example, the price will be going up after this month, or we only have 6 spots left.
So the seller provide a specific limit on how many spots left in able to pursue the buyers to avail the product or service. Then the last step is follow up.
Once you have closed the sale, your job is not done. The follow-up stage keeps your contact in customer which you have closed, not only for potential repeat business but for referrals as well. And since retaining current customer is 6 to 7 times less costly than acquiring new ones, maintaining relationship is the key. So, moving forward for the discussion, let's proceed to the buying process. A buying process is the series of steps that a consumer will take to make a purchasing decision. It is a standard model of consumer purchase decision making, includes the recognition of needs and wants, where at the side of the seller, the buyer recognizes what he wants to buy, the seller needs to attract and pursue the buyer to choose the product that he was selling. Next one is information search, which is we all know that there are several buyers that search information about the product that they need to buy after they go to the market. And as a seller, you are assigned to give information about the product that you are offering. Meaning, you need to market or advertise your product in able to pursue the customer to buy it. In the evaluation of choices, it is the step where the buyer will evaluate the product if it is worthy to buy or not. Then the next step is the purchase, where it is an actual purchase of the product that the seller would sell. And the last one is the post-purchase evaluation, where it is the step where the buyer will think if it is worthy to repeat to buy the product or not.
Being a unique seller is one of the greatest key to aim the top in the business industry. It will help the business to grow immediately and compete with the other famous brand. Being different is not the problem, it is the solution. To aim the unique selling process objective, you need to learn the process and understand each units that will help you to be more creative and unique when it comes on thinking and developing strategy. For me, I can say that in business, the more different you are capable to gain success and you can easily reach the goal and vision of the business. So that's all for today, and thank you for listening on my discussion. Be safe and God bless.